Hello and welcome to this edition of Doing Business in Rwanda. I'm Arnold Segawa. On this episode, we talk mining. 2016 was underlined by commodity prices having a particular slump. How did this affect Rwanda? Well, the country that was raking in over $200 million from the mining sector. In 2016, we did see meager receipts from the mining sector of just over $180 million. But there is a turnaround in play from the government of Rwanda. It is the Sustainable Development for Mining in Rwanda that is looking to have over $1.5 billion in receipts by 2024. On this episode, we seek to see how the government is going to use the private sector and all the other stakeholders to achieve this target. This is Doing Business in Rwanda. Rwanda is looking to increase investments that are in line with improving the mining sector's recovery rate from under 40% where it stands today,
thereby increasing the volumes and also the quality of the material they are putting to the market. The third thing, probably the most transformative, is that the public sector is taking lead in additional exploration. And this is having two major effects. One is that the operators in the mining sector are now having access to the new geological information that will help them in optimizing their operations. While on the other hand, we are also making new discoveries of the current and traditional minerals, but also new and non-traditional minerals that are going to increase the diversity of the minerals that we put to the market. All these combined give us a confidence that we are going to be able to achieve the targets we have set for ourselves. Of course, the major aspect that will increase this is that as we do all this, additional private investments will be attracted into the sector and thereby contribute to the productivity we are aspiring for.
We'll need also some other steps to reach where the people must be more sensibilized and get also means, so more means, get access to low loans, when we are talking about investment, me, I'm always saying that we have also to focus also to local investors, because most of the people who are working in mining are locals. They are using their space. So I think with the sensibilization now, that can be maybe, it is not something that we cannot reach. So when we are talking about 1.something million, billion, it is in 7 years. And also think about the minerals, how it is going, the price is doubling. For example, wolframite. Wolframite 1 year ago, it was half price of today price. So that's why we can think, and the projection, we are asking also on the stock, how the stock is positioning. So I think there is also, there is a hope that that ambitious target can be reached.
The main idea now is aggregate small scale mines into bigger company, that company will be interesting for investors, interesting for some, for banks as well. So because in this time, the most important is the volume of the product. So nobody will invest in $5,000 mine. So everybody is looking for bigger picture, bigger figures.
Africa is home to the world's biggest mineral industry. However, most of the stones from the continent reach international markets as raw materials, reducing their value. Many stakeholders believe investing in a smelter or refinery would address the deficiency.
In this case, it's possible to create some refineries in Rwanda, but it's carry a lot of questions to create refinery, because it's a really serious question. It must be big, it must be supplied by material for 100%. It must be newest technology, and it must be well known on the world market as well, as other companies already on the market and take their shares. So to create new refinery, for example, in Rwanda, it will cost a lot of money and a lot of job to do.
Rwanda contributes to over 30% of the tantalum on the global market. This is used to make high-end technology devices.
The three T's are really, I mean, the tin, tantalite, and tungsten are the mostly needed on the market today. So means I want to encourage most of the people who are in that domain, that product will be needed. So they will be always coming back to us, whatever the case, because you know tantalite and tin and tungsten are now used in the high-end technology today, and that those products are founded in Africa, mostly in our region. So I'm saying that on the price, we'll still struggling on that, but one day I'm sure it will come.
It's a business that is supplying commodities that have a major share of global produce. Let me inform you this, maybe you didn't know, that for all the tantalum products that are on the market today, about 35% of tantalum that goes to the global market comes from Rwanda. When you think about a single country that has a contribution amounting to that much of the global consumption, yeah, one must see the opportunity for raising the capital investments into this sector across the different levels of the value chain. The one level of value chain that we are now attracting investment for is in processing and particularly smelting of all these commodities that we are producing in Rwanda, whether it's tin, tantalum, tungsten, and others. And so all these, we believe, are strategies that will add to the achievement of the targets we have talked about.
Rwanda Mining Board launched the Sustainable Development of Mining in Rwanda program, an approach to direct miners to evolve from illegal mining systems that have previously degraded the environment and also assist them adopt legal mining systems. This would see growth in mineral productivity and also immensely contribute to the long-term conservation of the environment for sustainable development.
One of the key issues that we were working with, particularly in the design of the program, mm-hmm. was to make sure that the environmental issues are front and center, the child safeguarding issues are front and center, the health and safety concerns as well, you know, we must talk about that, the standards of what's happening in those mines, that those are also front and center in terms of what we're ensuring that we help mitigate and reduce those particular costs to the particular program, but also to the wider Rwandan economy. So for me, I think environmental standards are critical because we know, any type of mining does have an environmental impact. Mm-hmm. The key is to make sure that, as you're, for example, undertaking your recovery in terms of sluicing, it's done in a way that you're not destroying the watershed and destroying millions of other people's lives in the way that, the kind of mining practices as well as the processing practices.
We are encouraging people working underground, which was not really a system. That system was done before by colonials. And after that, most of the people were using the open cast, which is not really environmental friendly. But underground, it is more friendly. There, here, I think you can see more. Most of the mining companies started doing underground. I think that can be one of the solutions.
Mining sector is one of the sectors that affects the environment, especially if it's not properly done, it's not properly planned, because there is some planning action that should be taken, and that takes into consideration environment, climate change issues, and social issues. So they normally do an environmental impact assessment before implementing the project, and that helps the developer or the owner of the project to take care of environmental and social aspects when he's implementing the project. And if he's captured during planning, then up to the exploration, mining itself, to the closure, then all those issues should be tackled and planned for implementation. Otherwise, if mining sector will be just done as they wish to do, then it will be affecting other sectors. As much as we recognize its contribution to our economic growth, but also we recognize other sectors like agriculture, like water resources. It supports different areas from hydropower to irrigation to water supply. So if you don't take into care of environment in our practice, we are risking to gain more and shortly from mining sector, but eventually we'll be importing water from outside, food, and also spending much more money to treat our people because they will be suffering from different diseases.
Many African countries depend on the production of metal and mineral products. This has been partly responsible for the disruption caused by external shocks and a low level of economic development.
We were the only country that was able to stabilize our currency very quickly and also registered very minimal devaluation rates. Even then, what was happening in Rwanda over the last 5 years was a very high spike in big capital investment projects. I'm not sure that we have the kind of large capital investment projects that require the import volumes that we're experiencing in those last few years, particularly also with the government strategy for sensitizing the country on consuming made in Rwanda and also encouraging new industries to establish in Rwanda and reduce the desire to import. All these, given also the volume of exports, are going to be increasing. Look, last year, we registered about $185 million from the mining sector alone. This year, 2017, the cautious estimate is that perhaps we'll reach $300 million in export earnings coming out of the mining sector. And so these are not small numbers if you think about the aspirations we have for attracting foreign direct investments in the country.
We need also to get a kind of one common market. So we cannot think only Rwanda or only Congo or other countries producing minerals that they can do that. If you can think making it as two or three countries together, that will be easy. Because most of the smelter, for example in Asia, their plants are run by the product coming from abroad. So means they are looking for minerals coming from abroad because their minerals cannot run their plants easily. Rwanda, we can. For example, we use to smelt the tin. Tin, as you know, is one of the minerals we are producing more than tantalite and tungsten. But if you think to make it on tantalite, we need to get more production. So either we double the effort, either we make it as, for example, East African Community, Central, some countries can put together their production and run it.
Morphing the mining industry into a billion-dollar sector. That is what the Rwandan government is looking at, together, of course, with the Rwanda Mining Board. That sums it up for this edition of Doing Business in Rwanda. For any feedback or to get in touch with us, just send us an email. That is dbir@abn360.com or just tweet us at dbirwanda. That sums it up from me and the team. Thank you for watching.